my God. I didn't realize I was running low. You know what? I need to go down here to this corner store and get me something to drink. Anyway, but you know what? Just in case Dorothy asks you, just tell her I took her keys down to the corner store and I'll be right back.
Well, if it's none of my business, then you tell her yourself. I'm about to sit here and see if I could win me some millions on this little game right here.
Well, you know what? Don't even worry about it because I'll be back before she even notices. Trust me.
I hope she'll come out now and catch her.
I'm trying to figure out why one of y'all won't answer this phone.
Because I already know it ain't for me. Anybody trying to reach me can call me on my cellular phone.
You probably don't even know what that thing is.
Dude, my cellular phone is...
Hello? Hello? I guess they must have hung up then. Mm. It looks like somebody calling from the police department.
Well, it's a good thing I didn't answer. They ain't trying to bail nobody out of jail today. It's probably somebody just calling here looking for Louise anyway.
Speaking of Louise, where is she anyway?
Oh, she said she was going down to the corner store. And by the way, she took your car.
She did what?
I'm getting
ready to call her right now. I done told that girl about messing with my car without my permission.
Okay, well, call her.
No, this heifer didn't send me the voicemail.
Mm-hmm. Calm down. Don't get your feathers all ruffled, you old hen. Look, I'm sure your sister just went to go get something to drink. Look, you know she likes to drink and all that alcohol. I'm sure she'll be back in just a minute.
It's your fault that she ever started drinking in the first place.
You can't blame me for that.
Back in the day, you were the one who introduced her to alcohol and all the other bad habits that she picked up.
You can't, woman, do you know how long back in the day that was? I just want to know when you're going to stop bringing up the past.
Probably when you admit that you are the cause for most of her problems and this family's dysfunctionalism.
Oh, no, you can't blame me for that either. Look, people just need to get to know the Lord like I did and get themselves together.
Since when have you had yourself together? Since you had that stroke, you have barely been able to walk. And you have barely been able to wipe your own nasty, crusty behind.
Wait, who are you calling nasty and crusty? You done been around since the invention of dirt. I mean, water just seemed to dry up whenever you come around. Look, all I know is that you need to stop worrying about your sister so much.
You shut up. You don't tell me what to do. I will worry about my sister for as long as I live.
Don't you tell me to shut up. Then if you're so worried about her, then why don't you get her some professional help for all that drinking?
She is getting professional help. You know she's going to AA meetings, and she has even started going back to church, something she seems to be enjoying.
Yeah, you're right. She go to AA meetings, and she go to church, and right after that, she go get drunk. And she seemed to be enjoying that, too.
You know what? I don't know why my sister has chosen to stay with you after all of the horrible things that you have done to this family.
Oh, I can answer that for you. That's because your sister know there wasn't nobody else going to put up with a drunk psycho. That's why.
You just shut up and keep playing that game. That's what you do.
I'm going to keep playing. That's what I'm gonna do.
I wonder who that can be.
Well, guess what? If you go answer the door, you wouldn't have to wonder. Perhaps then you could find out.
Oh, and maybe I can let you get your little cripple self up and go answer the door. After all, the doctor did tell you to start using those little wobbly legs more often, didn't he?
I hope you'll fall down the steps.
Who is it?
told you about calling me Dad. I told you to call me Mr. Ben.
Sorry about that, Mr. Ben. It looks like you are feeling a little bit better than the last time I saw you, huh? And where's my mother?
Juno, looks can be deceiving.
Mm-hmm.
But anyway, your mother told your daddy she was running down there to the corner store, but she should have been back by now.
Y'all let her go to the corner store?
Look, I already told her where she was and what she was doing. She went to the store to get something to drink to get drunk, I'm sure.
Oh, my gosh.
She'll be back.
Why did y'all let her go to the corner store?
I'm telling you, she'll be back. But look, anyway, what are you doing over here? I thought you were still out of town.
Well, I just got back into town. I wanted to check and see if you guys needed anything before I have to leave again. And you know what? This house is really quiet. Where's Marley?
Only the good Lord knows where Marley is.
Mm-hmm.
All I can do is just pray for her. As a matter of fact, I pray for all y'all. I really do. I sit down. I pray hard. Well, with the exception of everybody but that old daughter over there. I don't care what happened to her.
You need to care, because if I go down, guess what? You going down with me.
I ain't going down nowhere.
Mr. Ben, now be nice. Now back to my mother, you guys. I thought she told me she had a handle on her drinking problem.
Oh, yeah, she got a handle on it, all right.
Oh, she do, okay.
Uh-huh, she handle it in the morning, she handle it at night, she handle it all the time. But to answer your question, what I need, I need some money. That's what I need.
Okay, well, how much money do you need?
Jonah, I'm quite sure your father doesn't need money. He got his check yesterday.
Oh, okay.
How does Miss Nosy Rosy know what I need? And who told you I got my check?
Well, Miss Nosy Rosy is the one who handed you your check yesterday. Remember, Mr. C, now? Oh, I guess that PTSD must really be messing with your little mind.
Now, Aunt Di, PTSD is a serious situation. You know I'm ex-military. Please don't talk like
that. Look, and ain't nobody got no DTSD anyway. If I do, I probably got it from some of that food she been cooking. Sure. Anyway, look here. Your mama say that you starting to make some good money now, working at the military, huh? Guess that military must be playing off for you, huh?
Well, I guess you can say that, Mr. Ben, but what do you need the money for?
Oh, I need the money so I can move out of this dump. Yeah, this dump.
Ben, I know you didn't just call my house a dump. You need to be thanking God that you and Louise even have a place to stay, because you could be down there up under a bridge or in a homeless shelter somewhere. I can't believe you.
Let me explain something to you. I stayed and better holes in the ground when I was in the military. That looked way better than this place. Trust me.
Well, trust me. Maybe you need to get on up out of here and go find you one of them holes to stay in again. Oh, I forgot. You can't, because you do need somebody to take care of you, huh?
Oh, stop.
Well, I don't need nobody to take care of me. Ain't nobody taking care of me now.
Okay.
Juno, the only thing she's taking care of is that check. She ran out there to the mailbox the first of the month so fast, be smoke coming up from her feet.
Okay, you two, that's enough. You know, actually, I've been trying to find a place for you and Mother to stay. Look, see? I found this senior citizen home right here. Look
senior
at the floor
citizen?
Feet. Yeah, senior citizen.
Look, you ain't got to find no place for me and your mother to stay. Just find somewhere for me to stay. Because your mother can stay right here with Dutch. Them the two that really need each other.
Okay, well, in that case, get to clicking your heels right now. You can come on, because you know I don't mind helping you pack either.
Okay, you two, that's enough. You know what? Let me call my mother and find out where she is.
Good luck with that.
You guys. But this is strange. She's not answering me either.
Well, you know what? You give me a ring, too, when you catch her, and let me know you found her.
Look, I already told you what she was doing. She probably somewhere getting drunk.
You know what? I just don't understand why she's not answering her cell phone.
Look, I can't understand why you keep trying to call her. Like I said, she gonna come staggering through the door, drunk in just a few minutes. Watch what I tell you.
You know what? Maybe I do need to go and look for her. What about that?
Well, you can go look for her, but I'm telling
you. She's not answering this phone.
She'll be here in no time.
John, what are you doing calling on my cell phone like that?
See, I told you.
What do you want?
Mom, I was only calling you because Aunt Dot has been worried about you. Where have you been? Are you all right?
Don't I look like I'm all right? Look, see? Your mama still look good for her age.
Before you call, you just staggering.
No, I'm fine. I don't feel like sitting down right now. Now you don't tell me what to do now. Louise,
in, and who gave you permission to drive my car?
Oh, see, what had happened was all I did. Went down there to the corner store, and now I'm back home. So what's the problem?
The problem is you didn't have permission to drive my car. Oh, and you claim you went down to the store, but I don't see any bags, so what did you buy?
Okay, that's it. I ain't heard enough. I ain't already told y'all what she was doing. And one of these days, y'all gonna learn to listen to me. You know, I really don't have time for this. Oh, Lord, I don't have time for this circus act. I'm going to my room so I can lay down.
Mother,
what?
Don't you think it's too early to be drinking in the morning?
Who said I was drinking? You don't see me with no alcohol, do you?
I don't see it, but I sure can smell the alcohol on your breath.
You know what, Jones? Maybe she'll listen to you, okay? But I'm going to go on in here and check on him, because ain't no telling what he's about to do. But can I tell y'all something? Sometimes when he fall down, it be so funny. It do.
Blue.
Yes, it do.
No,
Dot. Whole thing. Ben fall down.
Oh, my Lord. Here she goes.
And Ben get up. Ben fall down. Hilarious.
You know what?
What?
I'm so tired of people lying on me, saying I've been drinking when I have not been drinking. All I did was went down there to that corner store, and they was passing out some savage wine. And
really?
You know,
they were passing out wine this early in the morning? Really?
Anyway, Jonna, what are you doing here? I thought you'd still be out of town or something.
I only came by to check on you guys before I have to leave for my next assignment. Mother.
What?
You promised all of us that you would stop drinking.
All I had was two bottles of wine and a bag of chips. What's wrong with that?
But you shouldn't be drinking anything at all. Aren't you even worried about your probation officer finding out?
No, and who gonna tell? Certainly not me. What you gonna do? You gonna tell her? You gonna drop a dime on me?
No, ma'am, I'm not. But she's gonna find out when you go and get tested.
What's the day?
Friday? Why?
Oh, she won't be back over here until next week. I'll be fine by then.
Mother, are you trying to go back to jail?
No.
That's exactly where they're going to send you.